Well, welcome. Thank you for joining me, and welcome to all my viewers in the United States and around the world. Hope you're having a great day. Want to talk to you about something today. Seems like sometimes when you're really wanting to do something, either a big thing or a little thing in life, sometimes just things just completely, constantly, just they don't go your way. They don't go the way you want it to go. Okay, so that's life. Okay, but I want to read you a chapter, not a chapter, but a passage here out of John. Okay, and in my opinion, you can apply this to not only healing, but you can apply it to a lot of things in life. This frustration of wanting to do something, and you know that God has put it on your heart, and you really are going for it, and then it seems like the enemy just comes in and tries to mess things up for you. So I want to read the word, because the word of God is more powerful than almost anything. I mean, it's more powerful than anything, okay? And the prayer of agreement is more power, is powerful too. So I'm going to read, I'm going to start in John, okay? Now, I want you to listen, okay? And then I'll talk a little bit more and pray after this. John 5, after this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now there is at Jerusalem by the sheep market a pool, which is called in the Hebrew tongue Bethesda, having five porches. In these lay a great multitude of impotent folk, a blind, halt, withered, waiting for the moving of the water. For an angel went down at a certain season into the pool and troubled the water. Whosoever then first after the troubling of the water stepped in was made whole of whatsoever disease he had. And a certain man was there which had an infirmity 38 years. When Jesus saw him lie and knew that he had been now a long time in that case, Jesus is God, and so he knew, he said unto him, Wilt thou be made whole? The impotent man answered him, Sir, I have no man when the water is troubled to put me into the pool, but while I am coming, another steppeth down before me. Jesus said unto him, Rise, take up thy bed and walk. And immediately the man was made whole and took up his bed and walked, and on the same day was the Sabbath. The Jews therefore said unto him that was cured, It is the Sabbath day, it is not lawful for thee to carry thy bed. He answered them, He that made me whole, the same said unto me, Take up thy bed and walk. Then asked they him, What man is that which said unto thee, Take up thy bed and walk? And he that was healed wist not who it was, for Jesus had conveyed himself away, a multitude being in that place. Okay, I'm going to stop right there. Okay, you see the frustration of this man? He would try to get in the pool when the angel came, and then just when he was getting in the pool, some other guy or somebody would get down there in front of him. And so this is what I'm talking about, this frustration. And so I thank you, God, Jesus, that you're right here right now in this video. And I believe that with all my heart, because you put this chapter on my heart to read. And I lift up the people out there in video land, in YouTube video land, and wherever you might be watching this from. Father, I just pray for you to heal these people, to lift them up, Lord, to take up thy bed and walk, to lift the burden, whatever it is in their situation, Father, to change the situation for them, for the better, God. to make their dreams come true, God, little by little, much by much, from faith to faith, from glory to glory. And I thank you, God, for all of this, and I pray it in the name of Jesus. Amen. And I give you all the glory, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay, everybody, thank you for watching. Now, you receive that, okay? You receive a miracle for yourself, okay? And walk in the Word. Walk in the Lord, and He'll give you many miracles. Okay, bye-bye.